What is up, everybody? SmackedWookie here, and I am on day 6 of ditching Windows for Linux on my gaming PC. In my last episode, I showed you how to install CachyOS, which is an offshoot of Arch Linux, and how to log into Steam and Heroic Games Launcher. I showed you how to download and import games. Today, I'm going to show you how to launch games and do some light troubleshooting if a game doesn't launch. For the games that do launch, I'm going to do some light benchmarking. Nothing too crazy. The first game I'm going to try to launch is Cyberpunk 2077. First thing I did was enable Mangohud, which is a performance overlay. When I click play, it does a quick installation of the prerequisites. This took about a minute. The GOG launcher appears. This can be skipped with a launch argument, --launcher-skip, which I need to add to Cyberpunk and Witcher 3. And Cyberpunk just works. I don't need to fix anything or change any settings. It just works. I'll just do a quick settings check and then run the benchmark. I'm running it at 4K with ray tracing turned on. I'm not expecting crazy performance. I'm getting between 45 to 60 frames per second, depending on the scene. The benchmark has changed since the last time I played this game. It used to be longer. Like, there was a car, you used to drive through it. I'm not sure what happened. Don't know why they changed it, but looks pretty good. The next game is Hogwarts Legacy. This game gave me some problems in Bazzite. The game would launch, I could hear audio, but if I moved the mouse around, it sounded like I was interacting with the menu. The game was just completely black. And Hogwarts Legacy works. Same as Cyberpunk, I'm running Hogwarts Legacy at 4K with DLSS enabled and ray tracing turned on. We're going to start right where we control our character for the first time.
Are you alright?
And I'm maxing out at 60 frames per second despite the in-game cap being 120.
Perhaps a bit.
And that's because I have VSync turned on and my capture device I used supports up to 60 hertz. I used a capture device because I recorded this the same night I installed CachyOS, and I haven't installed OBS by this point. Anyway, my GPU was running between 80 and 90%. I probably would have gotten around 65 frames per second in the cave.
I can't believe he.
And it was stable, which makes for a smooth gameplay.
Got into that damn thing? Attacking a carriage mid-air?
I'll revisit this with a longer video once I get OBS.
Sir, where are we?
I'm not sure, but that key you discovered was clearly a portkey.
Portkey?
An item enchanted to bring whoever touches it to a specific place.
I'm feeling better, sir, if you'd like to look around a bit.
I would, but stay close. We've no idea who created this portkey, or why.
And now, Death Stranding, another game that just works. I didn't need to make any changes or install anything extra. Graphic settings are minimal. I'm running 4K DLSS quality, depth of field, motion blur, and fill grain are all disabled. All other settings, which isn't much, are set to ultra. Again, I'm capped out at 60 frames per second because of the capture card, but frame rates are smooth and stable. No hitching. Everything looks great. I haven't gotten too far into the game, but it's strangely immersive despite much of the gameplay so far is just a walking simulator. Also, without the capture card, I usually get 120 frames per second with my RTX 3080. I almost didn't include Final Fantasy VII Remake because it's another game that just worked, but it wasn't perfect. You can tell from the frame time graph that I was getting some bad hitches. I don't know if that was due to shader compilation because of new effects, or just loading new effects, but when I changed my frame rate cap from 60 to 120 frames per second, the hitching wasn't nearly as bad. I do remember seeing some things that the in-game frame rate limiter wasn't great. This was also a problem with Windows that was potentially fixed by running the game in DirectX 11, but that prevented you from playing the game with HDR. That'll be something to try on CachyOS. I'll definitely be doing a video of Chapter 1 of this game because it's one of my favorite segments of any video game.
Enough of this. Was never in doubt.
And I can't feature Remake without adding Final Fantasy VII Rebirth. As you can see, I can get the game to launch, but I can't quite get it stable. I start off good here fighting the Ninja Turtles. But when I go to fight the gecko and the penguins, I see some stuttering. I have some frame rate drops going into and out of menus. It's not as bad here with the capture device as it usually is, but I think that's also because of the frame rate cap. Rebirth was a challenge to get going even on the Windows side. It's a poor PC port that runs full screen at whatever resolution the desktop is. I worked around it by setting my desktop resolution to 2560 by 1440, but I can't set that resolution in CachyOS. It's 3840 by 2160 or bust. With the amount of time I spent trying to get Rebirth running with acceptable performance, this might be a game that I would reinstall Windows on my 500GB drive. Let me know what you think. Should I keep troubleshooting and testing Rebirth, or dual boot with Windows? Finally, Witcher 3. Wild Hunt. This is the first game I tested that did not work the first time. I went in the settings to change which version of Wine and Proton is used, and the versions I had installed didn't work. Now, you might be asking, Smacked Wookie, I'm new to Linux. What's Wine and Proton? And I would respond with, that's a very good question. Wine and Proton act as a translation layer between the Linux operating system and Windows games. Proton was developed by Steam. Most games work with newer versions of Proton. Some games you'll need to use an older version, and in the case of Witcher 3, we're going to have to find and download a different version of Proton. And to do that, I'm going to use a program called protonup-qt. It's a quick install. Just open up Terminal and run sudo pacman-s protonup-qt and hit enter. It's a quick 20-second install. Once that's done, open protonup-qt. Don't forget to exit out of Steam or Heroic Games Launcher. Whichever versions of Proton that you download won't be available into your game launchers until the next time you restart the app. So you might as well do it now. Select the game launcher you want to install the new version of Proton for. Here, I'm going to select Heroic Games Launcher. And then I'll select GE Proton 1025, which is a fork of Valve's official Proton. And just so you know, Proton is open source. I went ahead and added it for Steam as well. While that downloads, I'll test out Witcher 3. Before I launch the game, I need to go into the game profile settings. Click on Wine, and then select the new version of Proton I just downloaded. Inside the tower, I'm getting 60 frames per second with ray tracing turned on. Once I get out to the balcony, I'm between 55 and 60. And once I'm in White Orchard, I'm usually between 50 and 60. That does it for today's video. I'm having a much better experience so far with CachyOS compared to Bazzite. Just from the eye test, I'm getting pretty good performance compared to Windows. All of the games, with the exception of Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, are playable, but Rebirth presents itself with its own set of challenges. I'm excited to finally start playing some games now. Leave a comment below if you saw something in my library that you want to see a longer video on. Also, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you like what you see. You know the drill. It helps me out a lot. I'll see you next time. Later.